Shields quarterback. I see he's listed as number one on the depth chart here, or is that sort of an either or type thing?
Still an either or. We're just going to make our announcement Saturday, just because we don't have to, but we had to put down somebody, and we just went by age and the way it ended up last year, so that's why we did that. So
what's making that decision so challenging? I mean, it kind of sounds like, you know, you got two guys who played a lot of minutes last year, pretty even in terms of production. I mean, what would you say to that?
A little bit of everything, that and just maybe make it harder for Augustana to prepare, not knowing who the guy is. They do a little bit some things different, but probably that, and just to keep them both working hard. They'll both play before the year's over and probably before the game's over. So a little bit of just because we don't have to.
So you're not sure about choosing one guy? It's kind of...
Yeah, we'll pick right at game time. Right now is going to be our plan.
You guys did that a little bit offensively last year too, just by necessity, and also just sort of trip people up. But it seems like the rest of the offense, you guys have pretty good confidence in just who you've got coming back, and receiving core and linemen and running backs. It seems like your offense, other than the quarterback, pretty well set.
We are. We're ready to go. Like I said, kind of been ready for a week now, just by our defense doing a lot of things they're doing, and having good practices and familiarity that way. But yeah, we've got our group of guys up front, and the receivers and running backs ready to go.
Well, it sounds like pass protection can be kind of a strength for this team if you have four starters back. I mean, could you talk a little bit about that offensive line group and what they can do?
Yeah, we have a preseason All-American at center and left tackle. Those are pretty good guys to, you know, have good players at those spots. And our left guard, Jay Krause's playing as well as anybody on the team right now. And Ben Johnson's improved a lot. We got to really replace our right tackle. And that's the one guy that we got to see how he's going to play. But that group's got experience, and they're still, you know, relatively young. They'll all be back next year, so that's the good thing about them.
Yeah. Could I get you to maybe, you know, tell me some of the strengths of both of these quarterbacks? I mean, since you haven't chosen, I mean, what stands out about each of them?
You know, they both really run well. Everybody thinks Hein runs a little bit better. He's probably bigger, but Ryan does really run well. We just don't like to run him as much because of his physical stature. But they both are equally strong-armed. Jordy may be a little stronger in arm than Ryan, but they're just both getting some experience now, and that's the key. Last year when they both played, Jordy didn't have that transferring, and Shields will be his third year playing now, so I think their strengths are going to be some game experience for both of them.
Yeah. I guess I would just ask you a little bit about Augustana. Obviously, I think you guys played 2 years ago. It was sort of a lot of low scoring, more of a defensive battle. I know they have a pretty good quarterback and it's pretty good offense. What else can you say about?
Yeah, we didn't play very well at all down there last time, and we didn't throw the ball well, and I think we were 1-for-18, so you're not going to win many games doing that, and had turnovers and special team problems and just kept our defense on the field too long. But they're a good team. They were 7-4, should have beat a couple more good teams, Duluth, and they lost in overtime. They have an experienced quarterback, one of the more athletic kids coming back. So they've got a good ball team. You listen to their coach, he feels they're better than they were a year ago off a 7-4 team. So now it's going to be the turnovers, the special teams, who just kind of has the better opening first game, I think. Well, not turn it over, I think will be big keys.
Yeah. Well, it's definitely different for you guys, obviously. You're not quite as great unless you're 3-8. So what's the feel for you guys and how you can improve from last year?
Well, you know, we have to do it starting out offensively, just not turn the ball over. We are leading the league in that, so that's a goal, is to just give ourselves a chance and at the end of third down be kicking the ball in some shape or form, a field goal, a PAT, punting, something to that effect. And then defensively, we just gave up a ton of big plays, which was uncharacteristic for us. And make them earn it, and then special teams are not very good at kicking and punting the ball. Last in the league in punting, so field position didn't help us. We couldn't ever down the football on kickoffs. So I think, you know, a lot of those factors led to how we played, but offensively we just can't turn the ball over, and defensively just got to keep in front of us.
Have you addressed those special teams issues?
Well, we'll be playing Isaac Anerud. We redshirted him last year. He just wasn't quite ready to go with his punting. We have really addressed it by just having a more talented guy kick and punt the ball. and he hasn't played before, but you watch him and he's got one heck of a strong leg. He's further along than our All-American Zach Polkinen was a couple of years ago at his age, minus the game experience and that, but he's going to be fun to watch out there when he connects with the punts and the kickoffs and everything. He's going to be a really, really solid addition for us offensively.
Okay. What do you mean by he never played before?
He was a redshirt last year.
Oh.
So he, this is his first year playing. He'll be a true freshman out there, a redshirt freshman. So hopefully he's a gamer and kicks as good as he does in practice or even better.
Yeah, is he a former soccer player too? Or?
He did, very much like Zach. He was at Rogers High School. Only played soccer, then they got him out for football as the kicker. And when he came here, he really hadn't done any punting, and that's the part where he's drastically improved. So,
obviously, you know, two quarterbacks still fighting it out for the job, and I know Coach hasn't named a quarterback yet, but what do you think are your strengths? What do you think you bring to the table?
I'd say my arm ability, throwing the ball is kind of my strength. Obviously, Jordy does great things with his legs. I'd say I'm probably most comfortable in the pocket, but there's not a lot of things that I'm uncomfortable with as well. I feel like, you know, there's a lot of things that me and Jordy both can do well. And, yeah.
Do you guys don't really know yet who's slated to start?
Nope. It's said to be a game time decision, so we're just rolling with that.
How does that affect your preparation?
It doesn't. It doesn't. Me and Jordy both prepare as if we're a starter every week. Whether one of us gets the nod or not, we're going to prepare like we're starting the game either way, because in football there's one snap that can happen and another guy's playing. So.
Well, I know last season you guys, every now and again you would play every other down every other series, or you'd switch up a little bit. Is that something you hope maybe you could utilize to greater effect this season, just having both of you in there and maybe teams not knowing what to expect? Or
Yeah, I mean, it's going to be a scheme thing. I don't know if it's going to be a two quarterback system, but I feel like there's strengths to what Jordy does and what I do as well, so that's going to be on the coaches to decide, you know, for game time what's going to work best.
It's just as far as Augustana goes, you haven't seen him, I guess, 2 years ago, and that kind of, they show you guys out last time you went down there.
Yep.
What do they do defensively that's going to make it difficult for you guys, do you think?
They got a lot of guys returning, definitely in the secondary. They got some experience back there. Their middle backers coming back too, and just guys returning that are going to be a little bit more experienced. I think we got a good game plan put together. So.
I guess just overall, if you guys, I know you're excited to get back out there and start the season. Talked at the sort of beginning of camp about starting, you don't want to go 3-8 for a third straight year. What's,
yep.
I guess, what do you guys have to do to make sure that you can improve that record?
I think we just got to get everybody on board. I know everybody can see outside looking in that we've got a lot of talent. We just got to utilize that and get it all going in the same direction. And as long as we can do that, I don't think we're going to have any issues. So.
All right, so Colton, guys, I know, getting ready to start the season. What can you tell us about Augie? I know you haven't played him 2 years, I think, and I remember that game was a really low score. It was like 12-0. It was kind of a low scoring defensive type battle.
We know they got a good quarterback. He's a pretty athletic guy, and they're going to be a good ball club, that's for sure. They had pretty good defense last year as well. A lot of their O-line's back and all that, and they're definitely, they're going to be a good ball club for sure.
What do you got? Is there anything specific you guys have been prepping for in this game week preparation?
Basically keep the quarterback in the pocket because he can really get out and run pretty much.
Yeah. I guess in general, obviously, talked at the start of the season just about sort of improving the record. Don't want to be 3-8 seasons. What's your guys' outlook right now going into the season?
Well, we know we're talented, that's for sure. We got pretty much everyone back on our offense, and we did some things defensively, so, we have a lot of confidence coming into the year.
And I guess, defensively, you've got a couple of experienced guys, but it seems like a lot of youth on defense.
There is some youth, but there's a lot of talent, too. So, there might be a little bit of growing pains, but you guys might be a little surprised on the D-back. So.
Yeah, it seems like you guys are usually pretty solid defensively, and it seems like you guys always, both of you, Yon are always making work back there. So,
yep.
So
So, do you have any?
Yeah, I think I read you guys have 8 starters back on offense. I mean, right. I don't know if there's been a choice made at quarterback. I haven't seen anything on it, but I mean, what's the outlook offensively?
They did some pretty good stuff, and Bagnell recently got hired as the old coordinator, and he's a really smart guy, and they're definitely, we have a lot of confidence in them this year. So,
how many linemen do you guys have back?
Defensively or offensively?
Offensively.
We have 4.
4 back.
4 out of 5.
Okay. But yeah, I mean, 4 linemen, I mean, you guys have to feel pretty good about being able to protect, right?
Absolutely, yeah, and I mean, our skill guys, like receiver-wise, I don't know if there's a better group of guys in the league than what we have at receiver, so.